Versen.
Nani? Oba, これは。
So good morning, good afternoon, and good night. So welcome back to the video on special crime. So we'll be discussing what are the other special crimes like corporate crimes, religious related crimes, and economic crimes. So let's jump right through it. So religious related crimes. These are let's discuss first what are the definitions here. Religion, a particular system of faith or worship. So it includes yung Roman Catholic, Christian, Muslim, kung ano yung kanilang system of belief, paano yung paniniwala nila, pero it's more than that one. Pero kapag sinabi mong God mo si Rizal, for example, then that is your religion. And if there are rules and regulation in your religion wherein you believe that Rizal is your God, then that is your religion. And in fact, may ganun. Rizalista yung tawag, wherein sinasamba nila na si Rizal daw ang Messiah. So, ganun. And if you believe that anong ancient period na their God is the sun, then that's your religion. So, if there are rules and regulation in your religion wherein your God is the sun, then that's a particular system of faith and worship. So, crime is, we all know what is crime is. And separation of the church and the state, cult, and organized race. So, the reason why we are discussing this is because it has been in our environment here in the Philippines, we are very, very religious people. And these religious-related crimes has been looked. Hindi siya overlooked or underlooked. Hindi siya masyadong pinapansin. Pero marami siya. Kasi the PNP is more focused on street crimes like rape, drugs, murder, etc. Pero dito, under the veil of religion, then maraming crime ang nai-involve ang mga different mga sekta dito sa Pilipinas. So, one particular is mga pedophile na mga pare, lalo na sa mga Christian priests. So, bakit kaya konti lang parang bago ma-report ang isang priest, parang nagbiktima na sila ng maraming bata? So, kasi the beliefs of our people is that we see them as good people. Pero deep inside, they are wolves in sheep's clothing, di ba? Ano pa? Ito. Mga example ng mga pedophile priests. Noon unang panahon, alam niyo naman kung bakit tayo na-conquer, di ba? Through religion na conquer tayo sa Pilipinas, di ba? And noong unang panahon, if you are heretic against ka sa teachings ng church, anong ginagawa sa iyo? Pinupuran ka. Tinatawag doon ang yun ang tinatawag na Inquisition. So, maraming mga abuses ang church or mga religion natin. Pero dahil dito, kaya nga, dahil sa paniniwala natin na hindi parang mga sila is magagandang tao, parang they are men of God, hindi natin siya napapansin. So, meron dito yung separation of the church and state. So, actually, it began somewhat in 1700s wherein ayaw na ng, I don't know kung Italy yun, na marule ng isang pope. So they decided to separate the church and the state. So yung business ng church, hindi papakialaman ng state. So, for example dito, sa Pilipinas, is hindi natin tinataksan ang pagkokolekt ng church sa mga tithes, di ba? Either so lahat naman ng sekta I think is nagko-collect sila ng pera. Kaya some criminals use this as an advantage. So ang ginagawa, gumagawa sila ng sarili ng sekta at ginagawa nilang business, which is a religious related crime itself, di ba? And alam niyo yung sa INC, yung pag-iisahin nila yung boto nila. So hindi man siya masama, pero wag naman sanang ganun. Kaya nga na-separate ang church and state. Wag ding mangialam ang church sa state. Wag silang mangialam sa voting. So ganun dapat. So we are not yet, parang the PNP has no guts, has no balls, or hindi sila equipped to counter this religious related crimes. Kasi nga dahil religion has been a part of our culture and etc. So in other countries, may tinatawag silang cult, an organized braced with spiritual or ethical beliefs. It is parang ito yung panimula ng para maging religion siya. At ito is parang over devotion or over nagiget nga i-practice jay belief da. So it is bad. So kasi nakikita niyo to picture, it is taken from the Jonestown sa America in Florida, I think, wherein may isang tao na gumawa siya ng cult, at he believes na through killing themselves they will go to heaven. So ang nangyari, ginather niya yung followers niya, pumunta sila sa Jonestown at nag-suicide. So marami yung 300 plus ata yung uminom ng poison, and they believe that through that they will go to heaven. So look at this, yung mga crimes na ito, that is religious related crimes. Okay, so ito, Reverend Jim Jones, the religious cult leader, civil rights activist, hinted at the things to come. I love socialism and I'm willing to die to bring it about, but if I did, I'd take 1,000 with me. So yun yung sabi niya. He said during a sermon at his People's Temple Church in San Francisco. Just 2 years later, on November 18, those words became reality. So ayun pala. So Jones said, proclaimed Messiah, and ito yung ginawa niya. He organized more than 900 people to kill themselves. So ganun. Ganyan ang impact ng religion sa atin. Pero some people use this religion to commit crime, either for themselves, for money, or etc. And how do we combat this? We will be discussed on the other subject, other time. So let's now go to corporate crimes. Sabi dito, it's a type of white collar crime. So white collar crime is mga crime na kinakomit ng upper echelon, like attorney, businessman, politician, etc. Committed within their legitimate occupation for the benefit of their employing organization. Such individuals generally do not think of themselves as criminals, nor do they consider their activities criminal. Related to corporate crime is professional white collar crime. So corporate crime is crimes that is committed by the corporation or a person in the corporation for the benefit of that corporation. So example is tax delinquency, abuses within that organization, corporation. So for example, the tax delinquency, we take the ABS-CBN. So because the Aquinos is in power for how many years, and ABS-CBN is somewhat related to Aquino, Mr. Lopez. So yung ginawa is hindi sila masyadong nagbabayad ng tax nila. At ang nangyari is ABS-CBN is paying only 3.8% of their taxes. So dapat sana more than siguro 10 billion sana yung 20 billion sana yung tax ng ABS-CBN. Rough estimation ka lang yun. Pero ano yung 3.8% ng 10 billion? Siguro mga 100 million lang yung binayaran nila. 100 million plus, ganun yung range niya. So ano yun? Ano yun, di ba? Kagaguhan, di ba? Dapat sana makasuhan na yung ABS, pero nagsettle ang government ng payment agreement ng payment na lang. Kasi anong mapapalaman sa pagsuhan nito? Kunin mo na lang yung agreement. So Ganon, one example of that corporate crimes wherein the ABS-CBN, the owners of ABS-CBN, refused to pay their taxes. So, ganon. And employee abuses. Again, ABS-CBN, wherein they're during the parang the hearing on the ano ba yan, yung parang business permit ng franchise ng ABS-CBN. Maraming nag-testify na mga cameraman, even reporter, mga employee ng ABS-CBN noon na biglang nalis at hindi sila nababayaran ng husto, which is they say that they have been abused by the ABS-CBN. So ganun. So that's just some examples of it. So, 'di ba? Ang gago. Ang gago ng ABS-CBN. It is actually true kasi may nanalo na. Hindi ko alam, nakalimutan ko yung babaeng reporter na yun. Wherein, nanalo siya ng hearing-hearing na yan. Pero, they claim, mga dilawan, na wala daw. Wala daw abuses. They are turning a blind eye to the abuses of the ABS-CBN. So, those are examples of corporate crimes. And, do you think the PNP is equipped with that? With investigating that one? Hindi. Kaya nga, but na Senate hearing yan? Kasi, hindi capable ang PNP sa pag-build up ng case against ABS-CBN. Parang, giant kasi yan eh. Giant yung kinakalaban na ABS-CBN, di ba? So, I hope someday that our police will improve on that. Para hindi na lang puro Senate hearing. Senate hearing lahat. Napupunta lahat sa Senate hearing. And let's go to economic crime. So, economic crimes or financial crime refers to illegal acts committed by an individual or a group of individuals to obtain a financial or professional advantage. The principal motive in such crimes is economic gain. So, one example of economic crime is actually corporate crimes, different frauds, money laundering. So, they do this crime to take money. So, the money is their primary motivation. So, let's take a look at yung money laundering. Good thing na meron na tayong anti-money laundering law. So, we have now a system or a law that help us to investigate this crime. So, for example, may transaction. May nagtansak na tao ng 500,000. So, linagay niya sa bangko. Parang wire transfer niya from land bank to another land bank account. So, land bank will report that transaction. Automatic yan. He will report it to the AMLAC. And AMLAC will see to it, will parang request something, and then it will be investigated. That transaction will be investigated automatically. So, in your last activities is ganun. Gumawa kayo ng way on how to investigate this kind of crime. Nakuha na ang money laundering, or you can suggest more to investigate this special crime. So, that's actually the purpose of this course, is to somewhat to introduce you to the different special crime. And meron na yung isa ulit, yung terrorism. That is a special crime also because it has no crime scene and it is very complex to investigate. So meron tayong anti-terrorism law. Nakita ko sa law niya and sa IRR niya na meron na tayong parang definition ng terrorism. Noon kasi wala tayong definition ng terrorism. At yun yung problema. Matatawag ba nating terrorist 'yan? Kaya hindi tayo makakapag bigla-bigla na lang mag-file ng kaso na terrorism ang mga to. For example, the NPA. Ngayon na, pwede na tayong mag-tag ng terrorism. According to, actually, sa UN's description of what is terrorism, I forgot what it is. And sa definition ng UN, pasok doon yung NPA. Na terrorist, terror group sila. That they can be charged and yung problema is maapektuhan yung legal front ng NPA. Wherein, Gabriela, anak bayan, anak pawis, yung mga yun, they will be charged with terrorism because ganun yung description ng UN sa terrorism. So, maganda yun kasi totoo naman na mga legal front ng NP mga yun. Diba? So, those are pang magandang program, mga laws, na ginagawa ng mga congressista natin. So, sa last activities nyo, magbigay kayo ng paano? Ano pa? Anong mga law? Anong procedure? Ayun. So, yun lang. And thank you for listening and have a nice day.